5,236 miles. Outside air temperature, 66 Fahrenheit, 5,429 miles. 36,127 feet high, 5,737 miles. Time to destination, exactly 2 hours. On my flight to Shanghai, and when I get there, I'm gonna lie down in my hotel room and not turn on CNN. Don't wanna hear about a guy named Wiener sending pictures of his dick to a 15-year-old kid. Don't wanna hear no more Trump trash talking, or Hillary smearing Trump when she's got her own freak for a husband. Bill Clinton had more ladies than Iron Mike. He even got blown by an intern in the Oval Office, right? People sweep it under the rug because Bill's smile's so peachy and his skin is snow white. But yeah, here we are 11 days until the election. And Hillary's now associated with the child predator's erection. And Trump wants to build walls to keep out Mexicans. But illegal immigrants did a job for me, and they did it right, and it passed the building code inspections. I got nothing against people wanting to escape poverty and running for safety in the land of the Americans. It's a very hard election, isn't it? These two candidates are both walking, talking, power-hungry, steaming piles of white grits. It's a very hard election, isn't it? On November 8th, the best we can hope for is a president who's either cocky and pompous and talks a lot of shit. One who's got the FBI high on their priority list. Who's had the back of her hubby, who's the very definition of sexist. Or is even allegedly another word that I won't say that also ends with ist. People say, Mark, why don't you write like you used to? I say, well, people, because it's no longer 1992. There was no Craigslist back then, or 9/11, or YouTube. And San Francisco wasn't being taken over by Silicon Valley tools. And music venues hosted musicians, fools. And now it's all about booking DJs, dude. Those DJs are so badass.
Our DJ is so cool.
Back then I made $200 a week. Working at a hotel in Canada was the only foreign country I'd ever been to, and man, what a treat. For anyone who's nuts about maple donuts, the game of hockey, and has a taste for crappie or walleye. The beautiful old church down the street on the corner has been demolished, and it's now a Google Tech headquarters. And I can no longer buy CDs at Borders. There's music I'm interested in, my girlfriend has to order it from Amazon off the goddamn internet. And that transaction now makes it into my songs, and I know it's pathetic, but I'm just calling it as that is what it is. Down the toilet went this music business. People say, Mark, why don't you play Katie's song? Because she passed away, people, and I don't sing that one to cell phones. Katie used to sarcastically call me Dark Mark. She had a great sense of humor and a lust for life and a spark. And she would have supported my every creative decision. She understood growth and art, and she understood me as a musician. Here I am in China at the Orange Hotel. Google is banned, and so is Facebook, they tell me. They don't even have CNN. And when you walk around the streets, it's like you died and went to heaven. And the oranges are sweet, and this hotel is peaceful. This time off from the Hillary versus Trump slugfest feels pretty swell. You don't know it till you cross the ocean for a spell. But I think that the United States of America is going to hell. On a train from Shanghai to Beijing, herpes breaking out on my lip for the second time in the last 2 weeks. Show tonight that I'm flying off to Nashville to play the rhyme and to sing to a grand piano. But on my mind, on my mind, on my mind, on my mind, it's my plastic Christmas tree in my house out there on the snow line. Gonna settle down there this Christmas with my girlfriend and her cat, and hope that her cat finds that sneaky little rat. The that snuck in when the new roof was being done. You fix something, another thing becomes undone. And it goes on and on and on and on. If you buy a house, it was built in 1851. And I hope that on Christmas Eve the snow falls. It's magic when that happens, and I'm gonna sleep like Lou Rawls after 3 consecutive world tours. Next year I'm gonna take some time off. Organize my affairs, clean my chimney, and get my hot tub going. Gonna let some time turn without me brothers and sisters. Gonna spend some time with my girl and our little baby with whiskers. Beijing to USA and I'm way up in the sky. With my stuffed panda bear and a book called 1775. China was beautiful and the fans there were so polite. But it was all a dream in the grand scheme of things. I'm flying home. The Christmas tree lights bounce off the stained glass window and the brass lock on the old door. The burning stove breathes its very warm temperature, and I can't seem to get up out of my red and gold upholstered French furniture. The burning stove breathes its very warm temperature. It's a spooky sound, the way the smoke gets sucked out of the chimney top. And Segovia plays Mussorgsky and Ponce and Bach. It's Christmas Eve and the world is quiet. You cooked a turkey and the whole house smells good. I hear the cat nibbling her dry food. I hear her claws tap the hardwood. And I'm reading a Wilco Johnson biography book. A gift from Ireland that I just opened. Ain't nothing in the world that gets you thinking. Like Christmas Eve, babe, yeah, like Christmas Eve. I reflect on my youth all the way back to the beginning. This birthday coming was not part of my young dream. At the same time, I'm wise enough to count my blessings. I'm a pretty good poet, and I'm a pretty good guitar player. And I got a pretty nice house, and a pretty girl. And pretty nice friends in my corner. And I slept with a lot of pretty girls all around the world. And I can get on the phone with both my mom and dad. In my age, not everyone can say that. And I've accomplished a lot in music. If you work real hard at something, good things will come. And whatever you put your mind to. I'm like a flower that sprouted from an old blacktop parking lot. And I'm told my tastes like fine Belgian white chocolate. And I'm told that my tastes like semi-sweet chocolate. And I'm told my voice sounds like smooth dark chocolate. Maybe 'cause I drink so much hot chocolate. Maybe it's 'cause I eat so much milk chocolate. One of my PC friends eats strictly organic chocolate. And my other friend eats strictly imported Swiss chocolate. And tourists, they can't get enough of that Ghirardelli chocolate. Still got the hair on my head and that big old potbelly stove. And my girlfriend's lips taste sweet like a Florida orange. I got a lot, I got a lot, I got a lot. I got a mystical view that looks over the misty mountaintops. And tomorrow we'll walk through the Christmassy old gold rush town. And I'll whine to you about my growing anxiety, about my recent healthcare update, and my scheduled colonoscopy. My friend said, well, good luck with that one. Trump's gonna get rid of your healthcare. Ah, but that didn't faze me. His life will still be the same, and so will mine, with or without that orange hair. Next Christmas, my friend will still be designing artwork for CDs, books, and vinyl. And I'll send out my Christmas bonuses like I do each year, as that's my style. My girlfriend said, what do you want for your 50th birthday? I said, I just want my colon to be okay. I just want my cholesterol and testosterone levels to be okay. I want my eyeballs to not start turning gray. I just want my belly to be at bay. I want my third chin to go away. I just want to be with you if you'll have me until my dying day. She said, don't worry, you're just overthinking like you always do. On Christmas Day, baby, on Christmas Day, I know it's hard to shut your thoughts away. My back's more achy and my hair's a little more gray. My jeans are more baggy and my elbows strain. My legs are getting skinnier, my damn skinny, skinny legs. I hope someday my knees won't be replaced. They say Jesus Christ was born on Christmas Day. George Michael died the other day and I believe that was on Christmas Day. If you're hungry but don't feel like cooking on Christmas Day, may I suggest a place in the San Francisco Bay? Sam Woe's between Grant and Kearney on Clay. Chinatown stays open on Christmas Day. Give you a plate of duck fried rice. Some egg drop soup, it'll warm you up real nice. May I suggest another dish? For the whole family, get the whole steamed fish. I've lived through 49 Christmases in my time, you know. Spent Christmases eating pork and sauerkraut in Ohio. Spent Christmases eating turkey in Lake Tahoe. Spent Christmases eating conch bow shrimp in San Francisco. Spent Christmases in New Orleans eating gumbo. But there's been no Christmas exactly like this one, that's for sure. Just after Christmas, I texted my friend about how I had to get a colonoscopy and how I needed to be anesthetized and how I'd need a ride when it was over. She texted me back, ha, old people problems. /22/2017, it's quiet this morning here in New Orleans. My walls are painted off white and gray poupon. It's the season of Mardi Gras. At nighttime, guys walking around looking like little wings. Floats are going by and they're throwing out beans. The kids loved it's a nice time for many folks. Myself, I don't like the noise all too much. Got my blood test back, my glucose levels are good. Got my blood test back, my testosterone levels are good. But I need to start taking more vitamin D, to be specific, 5,000 IU, one per day. Oh, it's a good day, I got some good news today. Oh, it's a good day, I got some good news today. Everybody on St. Charles, having fun. Everybody, 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 everybody. Everybody's on St. Charles, having fun. Everybody, girlfriend's birthday recently, I brought her down here to celebrate. We've been together for a long time, and as it goes with my schedule, I've been out of the country for all her birthdays since we've been together. How wonderful it was to spend her birthday with her. Of all things, the movie Papillon came on at 9 p.m. or around there. It was on Movie Channel or maybe TMC, the guy set up by talking about some behind the scenes trivia that I didn't know about. Didn't know that Steve McQueen and Dustin Hoffman didn't get along during the making of the film. All the magic that can happen when talented people who don't get along very well work together. She was blown away by the movie just like I was when I was a kid. The last words Steve McQueen said before the movie ended at 11:59 p.m. were, "Hey you bastards, I'm still here." It's the same of this movie. Before as life goes, things reappear. And when you know I'm still here, and so is she. We woke up today and the sun is shining, and the parade doesn't start until 6:30 p.m. and it's beautiful outside, and the view looks over the garden district. And after all this time, I'm still in love with you. And after all this time, I'm still in love with you. And after all this time, I'm still in love with you. I look at the garden district view and I'm still in love with you. I look at the garden district view and I'm still in love with you. I look at the garden district view and I'm still in love with you. I look at the garden district view and I'm still in love with you. From a bad dream, she was on the bathroom floor crying. She said her father was no longer dying, that he had passed now, and she lay there. I fell back asleep, but my dream continued. I picked her up off the floor of my bathroom, helped her get dressed and carried her through the Chinese parade to the ocean. I said, "Be still and meditate on the waves." I woke up, I could have laid there all day. That's an option for me, my life is good that way. But I walked down my stairs and off into the pretty city. Girl working on my music video called me and said, "Mark, you're pretty cool for 50. And I walked to the health store to get some vitamin D. The girl working there said, "Why do you need this?" I said, "'Cause I just turned 50 and I got a vitamin D deficiency." She cringed and said, 50? Oh, that sucks. I'm sorry. I said, "Hey, it could be worse." And I said, "What are you, 20? She said, "Exactly. Good guess." I said, well, guess who else is? The nurse who prepped me for my very, 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 very recent colonoscopy. She said, ah, gross. You're right, pal. Life could be worse. Then I said, hey, do you want to be in my music video, baby? And she said, no thanks, and don't call me baby. I'm not your baby. I said, you stole that line from Scarface, baby. She said, yeah, I did. And she laughed. She had humor that way. She said, you're a real charmer. Anyhow, that'll be $4.98. I gave her a $5 and I said, hey, keep the change. We both laughed, we shared humor that way. I said, hey, my limousine's waiting for me outside. I gotta go. I know you're totally gonna miss me. She said, yeah, I'd come back soon, totally. And then I came back to my apartment. I listened to this piece of music from Sean. Our lives are cool, I'll just add words, and we got us a song. This one ain't gonna be a swan song, and I doubt that I'll add my nylon string guitar made by Yamaha. It's not gonna be our most requested song in our very vast catalog. I don't even know what this song is gonna be called. I guess I'll just call it somebody's favorite song. Somebody's favorite song. Somebody's favorite song. Now we're gonna add 3 seconds of silence, and it's gonna be an exactly 4 minute song. I woke from a dream I can't remember. Laying next to me was the most beautiful girl I'd ever seen. She brought me toast and an orange and a cup of black tea. Then I opened my paperback, the sound and the fury. She said, give me 20 minutes and I'll be ready. I said, okay, but as I waited, I got antsy. So I got dressed and said, I'll be outside waiting. The sun was warm and I was rubbing my eyes when a neighbor of hers came outside. She said, who are you? And I said, well, I'm just a guy. I asked her, who are you, Nancy Drew? She said, look, I live here. Are you waiting for someone? I said, maybe, but I don't see how it's any of your business, Nancy. She said, well, are you trying to get inside? I said, you know what? It's complicated, and I just woke up, and I'm tired, and I'd like to be left alone right now, if you don't mind. She said, no, everything's good. It's all good. I said, yeah, it is good, Nancy. Down the hill, she marched, and my girlfriend came outside, and we went and got lunch. And I kissed her goodbye, and I walked to an antique store. I had my eye on a green banker's desk lamp, but it wasn't there anymore. I noticed everyone was wearing green. Coffee shops and restaurants were unusually busy. I met Nathan and we got iced tea. I said, is it St. Patrick's Day already? And he said, nah, it's not until next Friday. Then we went into the studio and Nathan put a microphone on. Then he set up a music stand. I put my lyric sheets on it. Then he walked over into the control room. He said, "What are we working on?" I said, "Part two of what we were working on yesterday. Remember that piece of music from Sean?" He said, "Oh, somebody's favorite song." I said, "Yeah, that one. Somebody's favorite song." He said, "I guess it's no longer gonna be exactly 4 minutes long." I said, "That's true, but it'll still be somebody's favorite song." The reason I love you, number one, is 'cause your face lights my day like the sun, and 'cause we both love our cats like they're our daughters and our sons. That's the reason I love you, number one. The reason I love you, number two, this is how you comforted me when they kicked me out of the zoo for showing my nipples to the monkeys and the baboons. That's the reason I love you, number two. The reason I love you, number three, is 'cause we both like to take walks in the marina. 'Cause we both love Molinari's Deli. That's the reason I love you, number three. The reason I love you, number four, is because you're ladylike and sweet and totally adorable. And we both like to take care of our hardwood floors. That's the reason I love you, number four. The reason I love you, number five, is 'cause you're honest with me. You don't speak no jive. We both like the same songs off Peter Frampton Comes Alive. That's the reason I love you, number five. The reason I love you, number six, is because you're a wonderful lover and your body fits so perfectly with mine. We both love the same HBO series and documentaries on Netflix. That's the reason I love you, number six. The reason I love you, number seven, is because you bring me bottled water and yogurts and bananas from the 7-Eleven, a $4.99 DVDs like Sleepers starring Kevin Bacon. And that's the reason I love you, number seven. Reason I love you, number eight, is 'cause we rarely fight and we get along great, and you're prettier to me than Raquel Welch, Sharon Tate. And that's the reason I love you, number eight. The reason I love you, number nine, is 'cause you've got a beautiful name, Carolina. My God, you're so fine. And that's the reason I love you, number nine. The reason I love you, number 10, is because in addition to being my girlfriend, you're also my best friend. I can see ourselves together long after the end, and that's the reason I love you, number 10. I left the house to check out open mic night, though I was feeling very sick and my skin was a lighter shade of white. It was a young guy standing up on stage with a menacing pose and wearing black shades. He was singing to playback and wearing a black shirt with a silver skull logo thingy. He sang of flying around with paper wings and his grappling with Christianity. I tapped him on the shoulder and I said, "Hey, I liked your set. But he just shrugged at me and I thought, oh yeah, I get it. The rest were artists, mostly playing covers. But toward the end, a woman got up and read a very vicious poem that she had sent to an ex. She read it from her phone. It was venomous and intense, and she didn't miss a beat. And after its final hard punctuated this, the whole place erupted with applause and stood up from their seats. My nagging cough was getting worse, so I had to go. But I loved all the music and the support that everyone showed. For each and every artist, whether playing Coldplay covers or original pieces on Seagull acoustic guitars or Casio pianos. As I left and I walked through the cafe, I noticed colorful portraits. I noticed colorful portraits on display. All for sale, Bowie and Prince and Beyonce. Bright purples and blues and greens and golds. But the one that stood out was Mike Tyson, so no wonder I would have bought that one too. Nothing beats Mike's smile and his warrior face tattoo. Came home, the lights were out in my upstairs bedroom. I had to run an extension cord from downstairs to get a bedside lamp going. The cough kept me up all night. And my handyman came over in the morning and he solved the problem. By hitting a little switch on the wall, he called it a test button. And then he told me about his sister who had passed before Christmas. Due to an overdose on morphine while being hospitalized for an amputation procedure. Then he dropped me off downtown so I could get something to eat. And then I walked back home through the graveyard. Uphill and more uphill. And by the time I got home, my cough was so bad, tears were coming out of my eyes, and I had the chills. I laid down in the back bedroom. Like a KO'd fighter in a fetal position. Knocked down by a hard body blow, like what Roy Jones did to Virgil Hill. The room is white and cool. My girlfriend will be here tomorrow. It's sardines and ramen tonight. I can't wait to hear the sound of her car pulling up the drive. time, and this call is killing me. It's kept me awake for 3 nights, and every time I cough, it's like a Fraser hook shaking me. Cars, 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 swishing down the highway. Dogs, 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 woo, 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 in the yard. The night is black, 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 black. Now it's 5 a.m. and I'm coughing like a chin smoker, asthma attack. I'm close to sleep and I feel a dream coming. I see myself in the dream, the back of someone's head hit my forehead. There are 2 eyes right above my eyes. And blood is pouring from those eyes right into my eye. I force myself to wake and not let the nightmare happen. It's 5:30 a.m. and the black night is a slightly lighter shade of black. Spirits are tripping, I'm on high alert. I just wanna sleep, I just wanna fall asleep. But I can't, the cough is so painful and it keeps shaking me. I've not had a cough this bad since the winter of 93, when Katie and I spent the winter in Mendocino County. That house had a similar vibe to this one. A wood-burning stove, an awkwardly laid out old Victorian. And back then, I was reading a Hank Williams book. Now I'm reading a Game of Ghosts, but I still have that old Hank Williams paperback. My room to remind me of our time together. Man, how the times have changed. I now sit next to Caroline, but I'll remember you forever. Now Caroline's back, she brought back some groceries and is making chicken soup. The yard guy texts me, hey amigo, I'm outside, and I go out and I pay him. Small talk, 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 small talk. Small talk, small talk. Cough, 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 small talk. Cough, 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 small talk. It's a new day now. Weeks have passed. A photo of daffodils. Ah, this is a nice surprise. This comforts me. Daffodils. She sent a photo of daffodils and said that they came and went fast. I told her about mine and how lucky I felt to be able to see them this year rising up. We lost track for a bit, her and I. I was in the dumps for many days and nights, and I know that she was too, and that she was crying, because I was told about a message she left on somebody's phone. I tried the patching up by sending a photo of Orange California poppies. Those are her favorite, but our waves at the time were still choppy. She sent a black and white of a train in Navarre, but I acted like I didn't care and I didn't respond. The hurt still lingers, but slightly less each day. I lost part of her to an illness along the way. But with each night that passes, I'm trying to make sense of it, to make peace with it, and to find a way to cope. A Saturday morning, late April, the view is serene, and holding on to bad feelings feels inappropriate in its glory. The water is light blue at the bottom and military tan on top. There's a light breeze in the air as I poke my head out the window. Today I feel myself healing, encompassed by this beautiful view of the green hills and water, and looking at the photo you sent, a bouquet of daffodils.